Imagine you're running a billion-dollar factory for a global tech giant, and suddenly, the power cuts out. This isn't a hypothetical. For years, severe power shortages, especially during peak summer heat waves and brutal drought conditions, have sometimes crippled Vietnam's manufacturing plants in the north. This disruption doesn't just halt production lines, it risks billions of dollars in future foreign investment, threatening to derail Vietnam's explosive economic growth. So what do you do when your nation's ambition is about to be short-circuited? Vietnam's answer is a grand, audacious plan to not only solve its power crisis for good, but also to turn the country into a green energy superpower. With this huge plan, Vietnam aims to become a net zero country by 2050, and also clean energy exporter to its neighbors. Here's how a nation once defined by war is transforming itself into a leader in the global green energy race. A revolution at unprecedented scale. What's happening in Vietnam is an incredible, lightning-fast revolution. Between 2018 and 2023, the country scaled up its solar and wind capacity from virtually zero to 19.5 gigawatts, with solar being the biggest piece of the pie. That insane growth made Vietnam the number one solar power producer in all of Southeast Asia. This didn't happen by accident. It was a planned, targeted push that brought in billions in cash and proved that a developing country could literally leapfrog into a green future. The crucial catalyst. How did Vietnam go from being a non-player to a major solar energy producer in just a few years? The first big move was a policy called the feed-in tariff, or FIT. To put it simply, the government guaranteed an awesome price to anyone who could make renewable electricity and put it on the grid. This one move created a tsunami of private solar investment, and that was just the opening act. The government's second act is called the Power Development Plan 8, or PDP8. It is one of the most ambitious energy roadmaps on the planet. Approved in May 2023, the plan sets renewable energy as the cornerstone of the country's power supply by 2030. This plan would double Vietnam's power generation capacity from 78 gigawatts in 2022 to 150 gigawatts by 2030. In December 2023, the Group of Seven Nations and other wealthier countries pledged $15.5 billion in initial funds to support Vietnam's transition away from coal. The plan wants to reduce coal energy from 31% to 20%, hydropower energy at 19.5%. It aims to increase wind, solar, and biomass energy to at least 31 to 39%. Their contribution could rise to 47% if G7 pledges are fully implemented. It even has a plan for adding nuclear energy to the mix between 2030 and 2035. Projecting further towards the year 2050, under this plan, coal-fired electricity will no longer be present, and solar power is planned to become the top spot with an impressive 34.4%. Wind power will follow closely at 29.4%. And a new power source, hydrogen gas, will also be contributing 3.2% to the overall mix. These are not just some aspirational goals. Vietnam is actually taking concrete steps to achieve them. Vietnam has started construction on its first large-scale green hydrogen plant in the Mekong Delta. The 260 megawatts, Tra Vinh Green Hydrogen Plant is slated to begin operation in 2027. In February 2025, Vietnam signed a nuclear cooperation agreement with Russia and held talks with other potential partners like South Korea, France, and the United States about funding and technology transfer in order to have the first nuclear plant operational by 2030. In March 2025, Vietnam took another significant step toward achieving these lofty goals by unleashing its next big weapon, the Direct Power Purchase Agreement, or DPPA. This is game-changing. It allows huge electricity users, like the giant factories for tech and clothing companies, buy green power directly from private sources, skipping the state utility provider entirely. For companies that want to be sustainable and need reliable, clean energy, this is a huge reason to invest in Vietnam. It pulls the private sector right into the action, creating a market-driven race for green energy that will trigger the next big wave of development. And to make it all work, Vietnam is planning for a significant increase in energy storage, targeting 10 to 16.3 gigawatts of battery energy storage system, BESS, by 2030 to ensure the grid stays stable as renewables take over. The ultimate ambition. The unbelievable size and strategy of Vietnam's plan raises a huge question. Why do this? And why now? The answer reveals an ambition that goes way beyond just keeping the lights on. First up is energy security. Vietnam's economy is booming, and that means it needs a crazy amount of electricity to keep the factories humming and to meet the increasing demand from population growth and urbanization. Relying on imported fossil fuels is super expensive and geopolitically risky. By building its own massive renewable energy supply, Vietnam breaks free from volatile global markets and takes control of its own economic future. But being self-sufficient is just the start. The real goal is to become a major exporter of clean energy. The PDP8 plan has insane goals to export between 5 and 10 gigawatts of electricity to other countries by 2035. Can you even imagine that? A country that was dealing with power shortages a decade ago is now planning to become a clean energy exporter. As a matter of fact, Vietnam, Singapore, and Malaysia signed an agreement in May 2025 to explore the export of Vietnam's offshore wind energy to Malaysia and Singapore via a sub-ocean cable. Vietnam is also planning to build two gigantic inter-regional renewable energy industrial and service hubs. These hubs won't just make power. They will become centers for building wind turbines, solar panels, and other green tech, creating a new domestic industry and thousands of high-skill jobs. It's all part of a bigger plan to become the world's next great manufacturing hub. As global companies try to move their supply chains, Vietnam is making an incredible offer. Come here, and we will power your factories with stable, cheap, and clean energy. Vietnam's strategy is a bold and complex undertaking. It's a mix of aggressive targets, innovative policies, and massive investment. But what do you think is the biggest hurdle they will have to overcome to make this vision a reality? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. The hurdles, the risks on the road ahead. Of course, building a renewable energy empire isn't as easy as just setting up some panels and turbines. The single biggest challenge is infrastructure. The green energy boom has literally been faster than the national grid's ability to keep up. Due to transmission gridlock, excess electricity produced in the sunny south and windy central areas cannot be effectively transmitted to the north when needed. This transmission gridlock also forces some solar and wind farms to actually power down because there aren't enough power lines to carry the electricity. In a swift, top-down approach, Prime Minister Pham Minh Chinh directed state-owned Vietnam Electricity, EVN, to expedite and complete a new north-south 500 kV electric transmission line in record 6-month period during 2024. Continuous upgrading the grid is a colossal and expensive job, but it is critical for the PDP8 plan to succeed. The second major risk is the cost. Achieving the plan will require substantial investment of $135 billion. Thus, securing long-term and sustainable funding is a critical aspect of the plan's success. The third major risk is in policy and regulatory stability. While the government's feed-in tariffs were unbelievably successful at starting the boom, some investors have gotten nervous about changing rules and prices. That kind of uncertainty can scare away investors. To attract the hundreds of billions in private investment, Vietnam has to prove it has a transparent, predictable, and fair system. So, what is Vietnam's secret weapon? It's not just the sun and the wind. If that was the case, many African countries would have already become power giants. For Vietnam, it's that rare combination of audacious ambition, detailed strategic planning, and a government willing to move with incredible speed. It has laid out a crystal-clear, multi-billion-dollar blueprint with its Power Development Plan 8. It has created powerful incentives for private investment with policies like feed-in tariffs and direct power purchase agreements. And it has a bold vision to become not just a user of green energy, but a powerful exporter and a central hub in the global clean energy supply chain. Vietnam is using the energy revolution to supercharge its economy and lock in its spot on the world stage. If you found today's episode interesting, please like, subscribe, and share. It would be valuable to know your thoughts in the comments section. See you next time.